It's 1966. I mean, things like this aren't supposed to happen, really. I think Cincinnati lost its innocence that year.
Greenway Avenue still has that same 60s suburban look, and while people who live here now don't speak of it daily, the horrors of what took place inside a home on this block are vividly spelled out in dusty headlines from the time.
You have the upwardly mobile husband working 8 hours a week. You have the glamorous ex-airline stewardess wife. You have the beautiful daughter who apparently acted much older than her years in this lovely subdivision. They get butchered in their own home.
J.T. Townsend was 12 when Gerald Bricka, his wife Linda, and their four-year-old daughter Deborah were stabbed to death.
I had nightmares. I thought my entire family was going to be killed the first month.
And his fascination with the crime never left. Now it's a chapter in his 2009 book, Queen City Gothic.
I've received a lot of cryptic emails since my book came out with people that claim they know who the killer is, specifically who they are. But this needs to move beyond the whispers and the rumors stage.
It's what detectives are hoping for, too. In fact, they say they now have a handful of suspects they're considering, some deceased, some still living. And in just the last couple of years, they've sent boxes of decades-old evidence to be tested for DNA.
The chances of justice today here in 2013 are about as good as I've seen them since 1966.